So welcome back, welcome back. This is stoplearn.com tutorial on mini importation. How you can import your goods from China, from elsewhere, and sell it in your local country. So all this you see, we have actually made videos for all this, which you can find in our channel. We've shown you how much capital you need. We've shown you how to source for your product. We've shown you important things to know before buying. We've shown you how to know a reliable supplier. We've done this. Now today, we are going to show you how to negotiate with the Chinese. Interesting, isn't it? How to negotiate with the Chinese. Now I want you to understand that negotiation is a skill. People are different, and so is your approach to them. Before we continue, I will take you back to what we did before. Before you buy from Alibaba.com, make sure you download the Alibaba Mobile app and also download the WeChat app. These are the two things you will need to chat or contact your supplier. Also, I told you that WhatsApp is blocked in Alibaba, so WhatsApp is not reliable in China. WhatsApp is blocked in China, rather. So now the Chinese is quite different, and you will have to specially learn how to relate with them in order to get the best deal. There are lots of resources and academic studies out there for you to read in order to understand how the Chinese thought process flows. The Chinese themselves do exactly the same thing when they want to do business, say with an American. So you should spend a couple of minutes to learn how to approach them too. Harvard Business Review has an article titled "The Chinese Negotiation." You can find it here. You can find it in this link. Okay? You can just search Google or you open this link. It's titled "The Chinese Negotiation." So part of the article says Chinese negotiators are more concerned with the means than the end, with the process more than the goal. The best compromises are derived only through the ritual back and forth of haggling. This process cannot be cut short, and the compromise allows the two sides to hold equally valid position. While Americans tend to believe that the truth is as they see it, is worth arguing over and even getting angry about, the Chinese believe that the way is hard to find, and so rely on haggling to settle differences. This is very, very important. It does not just apply to Americans, it applies to Europeans and people of other countries. So this is the article from Harvard Business Review. The Chinese Negotiator, written by John Graham and McLam. I advise you to go through this, you know, for Harvard Business to, you know, to do a study, even linking it back to Chinese culture, it should show you that this is worth learning. Okay? Just go through this. In China, the intermediary, not the negotiator, first brings up the business issue to be discussed. You just have to read this. I've read it myself and it's worth it. Don't take things for granted. Do your homework, okay? Okay, so that is it. Now what this is saying is that other cultures might see truth as sacrosanct. If I tell you this is $10, then you should believe me that it's $10. And if you argue me, I might get angry at you. But that is not the way in China. In China, you have to, you see, it's a ritual. You have to haggle back and forth. You have to debate on the price back and forth. The Chinese believe that the way is hard to find, and so rely on haggling to settle differences. So before the all important haggling begins, I assure the Chinese agent, this is personally what I do. I assure the Chinese agent of my continuous patronage once she gives me a good deal and a high quality product. I assure them of increased volume of purchase in the near future. So, for example, you tell the Chinese that, hi, look. This product, if you buy, if you ship, if you send to me, if product very good, next time I buy many. Next time I buy one container. You know, tell them, you know, talk to them like this. It prepares their mind psychologically and mentally to treat you well, because they already see you as a potentially big customer. But as a mini importer, remember, you're just buying 5 pieces, 1 piece, 2 or 3. So originally they might not take it serious, but when they hear or when they understand that you actually is planning to buy a lot more in the future, they will take it more serious and perhaps give you a good deal. So this prepares her mind and makes her value you the more as a potential big customer. Once again, remind them that if they ship quality goods and if it sells, that I or you will increase your volume of purchase. This will make the Chinese want to talk to you and establish relationship. Also, show the agent a picture of your store with your business name. Now, this is very important. Chinese people work with evidence. Even when you don't show them, you find out they start chatting with you in a very friendly way. They'll ask you about your wife, about your child, about your display picture, your profile picture. You know, not because they love you, but because they want to set the atmosphere. They want to know more about you. Not because they care about you. They care about the business, not about you. Okay? Chinese don't care about you. They care about the business you are giving them. But before that business, they become so friendly. They want to know about your business. Are you a business person or you just want to use? Are you a returning customer or are you buying just once? Is it worth it? So now you have to play on their mind before they ask you about your business. Go before them and show them the picture of your store if you have, or you know, tell them your business name. You know, if you don't have a physical store, send them a link to your social media page, or show them that you're a reseller and not an end user. Show them your website, you know, anything. Believe me, they will take their time. If it is Facebook that is banned, they will have to go and get VPN. They will take their time and study what you do and understand you. Everybody loves a returning customer. You have to be careful when handling with the Chinese marketer. Know when to stop. The reason is that the Chinese manufacturer can use inferior or substandard materials to manufacture specially for you at your price. Okay? Generally, make your price research and know the bottom pricing for that item. Price slightly below the bottom price and know when to stop. I will recommend you also read Forbes, Negotiating in China, 10 Rules for Success. So the first one we saw is Harvard Business Review, and this one is Forbes again, 10 Rules for Success. Okay, so these things are very important. Now you ask yourself, why will Harvard HBR dedicate their time to study it, and why would Forbes do this? This is what Forbes have to say. Manage your own and your own boss's expectation. Have a negotiating strategy. Understand that negotiating in China is a team sport. That is haggling. Assemble a capable Chinese team and enlist the support of a third party. Remember that in China, a yuan is a buck. Leave your ego at home. Patience is a virtue in China. Learn to listen more and speak less. Don't set artificial deadlines. Control your emotion. Be fair, reasonable, and diplomatic. Nothing succeeds like indifference. So this is a view from Jack Pekoski. Okay? You have to do your homework. Try to understand how the Chinese mind works. Then, after you do all this, you are good to go. You can now go ahead and purchase the item you want to purchase. So, thank you. Next study, we are going to look at the best types of products to import and sell. Thank you very much.